May I please ask everyone to take a seat so we can begin the evening celebration. Distinguished faculty, friends, and guests of friends. First of all, on behalf of our batch, I would like to welcome you to the farewell celebrations of the 2013-15 MBA batch of the University of Colombo, Faculty of Finance and Management. We are so glad to see everyone here today. Time flies, and so much has happened in the last 2 years. The most amazing outcome, though, are the friendships and the relationships we have built with each other, and it will last us a lifetime, I'm sure. Thank you for being an amazing group of people. We hope to stay in touch and see everyone again in future gatherings and events such as this. We have with us tonight some very special guests. They are, of course, our lecturers. You might not remember what lectures they taught us, but I think those are not the things we remember. We remember the people we met, the interesting things they did, and the things we did together with them. I think I'm right to say that each and every lecturer that taught our batch made a lasting impression on us. We learned more than just theory from this. They were amazing people and will forever be our mentors and role models. As a tribute to our teachers, may I please ask everyone to give them a round of applause. We are also very glad to have some staff members from the university attend the event today, so I'd like to also welcome them. Without further ado, let me please invite Dr. Senathiraja, Dean of the Faculty of Finance and Management, to please give us her address.
Good evening, everyone. So I'm very much glad to be here and join with you for this grand dinner. So the batch 2013-15, the MBA students, on behalf of Faculty of Management and Finance, congratulations on your achievements. MBA of Faculty of Management and Finance is relatively young in the University of Colombo. As you all are aware, the University of Colombo, our faculty, is the youngest faculty. But today, it has gained a position among the most admired institutions in the world. The underlying reason for the achievement is you. Yes, the people you are sitting over there and the people, those who have set over last 15 years period of time. Today, your dream is getting MBA became true today. You got your MBA. It's because of your hard work, commitment, sacrification of many things in your life. I see this achievement interconnected with many groups of people. The important part of that, the academic staff and the staff of the Faculty of Management and Finance and other university faculties, those people sacrificed their life, their time, and they contributed a lot to provide many thoughts to you. In addition to that, I could say our university staff, including the university administration, help a lot to us. In another part, your organization, your superiors, your subordinates and employees, they have given fullest support for you. Apart from that, your family members and their support and sacrification is very important to get this MBA degree. Altogether, finally, it is an outcome of the teamwork of many different group of people. I still remember the stressful phases of MBA students when they are entering to the faculties. So whatever the stress you have when you enter, everything today disappears when you walk out the door with the MBA certificate. I could say today all the faces is a pleasant. I can recall the quote of Maclellan. Every struggle arises for a reason. It creates an experience or a lesson. A great journey, never easy. And the dose of hardship along the way is ever a waste of time if you learn and grow from it. I trust the habits of art, the cast of mind cultivated during your time here, have prepared me with high quality intellectual social competencies. Today we have taken many steps to reposition the MBA program, as well as we have revised, restructured the existing curricula syllabi to match with the changing global environment. Finally, I would like to praise the effort of those two of you throughout the year and who are with you today in person or Skype, your loving family members and friends, to all of their our heartfelt thanks and warm applause. In addition to that, I will take this opportunity to thank the coordinators, especially Dr. Nuwani Amarathunga, the weekday program, and the unit coordinators, all previous program coordinators, and the previous deans and administrators of the university, and all the people, those who have supported us to complete this batch on time. You are welcome to upgrade your knowledge to the faculty. You are welcome again to, we are having many programs, MPhil and PhD, all this on the way. I wish all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam, for the encouraging word. Like Dr. Senathiraja mentioned, the unit the coordinators of the course have been a great source of support to us. They've done a lot of work behind the scenes, really. So I'd like to take this opportunity to please invite Dr. Pavitra Kailasapathy, our unit coordinator, to speak a few words also for us. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me for your graduation dinner and asking me to say a few words. I will really say a few words. I know the last 2 years would have been quite hectic for you all with work, family, and the MBA program. I hope apart from the hard work, you also got opportunities to have some good times and make new friends and network as well. I always mention to new MBA students when they are starting their MBA program that when they are starting, they will be at the D of divorce, and when they finish the MBA, they will be at the E of divorce. I hope that really, literally didn't happen to any of you. But I know it had a lot of hard work and not hardly working. So I hope you did work hard and gain knowledge and that you achieved your expectations. Now your next phase of life starts, post-MBA. So talking about post-MBA and your next phase of life, recently I met an MBA alumna and he was saying initially it was nice, but then at home they have been waiting for 2 years with his absence. So now that his MBA is over, he has a lot of household responsibilities and looking after the children. So now he's looking for another course to do during weekends to get out of it. So when he was doing MBA, he was like, when will this, oh, already people have started raising hands, okay. So when he was doing MBA, he was like waiting for the MBA to finish. But now when he finishes that, he wants to do another course just to get out of it. So I don't know what your post-MBA phase is going to be. But anyway, whatever it may be, all the best. So, talking about the next phase in life, your program coordinator, Dr. Nuwani Amarathunga, is also getting ready for her next phase of life. So this function is going to be something like a double farewell party. I know the final results for your batch is still not yet released, but anyway, I take this opportunity to thank you all for choosing University of Colombo to pursue your MBA, and wish you all the very best for your future. Thank you.
Let me now please call upon a very special person who is an excellent guide in the form of a mentor. Dr. Nuwani Amarathunga, you are not only our coordinator, you are a friend, authority and guide all rolled into one person. Thank you for your guidance, friendship and for all the extra efforts you made to help us grow and the challenges you encourage us to face through the duration of our MBA. It was certainly not a cakewalk for some of us, most of us actually. We will always be grateful to you for your support and kindness, and we will miss you a great deal when you leave us at the end of this month. So may I please call upon Dr. Nuwani Amarathunga to come and speak a few words for us.
Dr. Kailasapathy, Unit Coordinator, Postgraduate and Mentorate Development Unit, Professor Jayakuri, Director, Institute of Human Resources Advancement, University of Colombo, all the lecturers, non-academic staff members, and my dear students. It is indeed a privilege to stand in front of you for the last time, maybe, to deliver a few words. Before I move on, let me take this opportunity to extend a big thank you to the organizing committee. I know they went an extra mile to make this event happen. We gathered at UCSC auditorium, if I recall, a little above 2 years back in October 2013 for a ceremonial Today we are here to celebrate on the completion of the task or accomplishing the task. I'm sure the last 2 years we have been inundated with coursework, continuous assessments, examinations, sleepless nights. Nevertheless, you have now seen the light at the end of the tunnel. So I'll make sure that the balanced results will also be out Monday. Without no hesitation and exaggeration, I can say 2013-15 MBA midday batch was exceptional. Let me bring a few anecdotes from the recent past. The batch had one mission to march towards the main objective of finishing all their exams and submissions on time, which they accomplished. The compromises they made were admirable. They agreed to come for a particular lecture. This is an example. This is how I'm drawing your attention to the memory line. Lecture for 5 consecutive days, if I'm not one lecture, 5 consecutive days, including 1 weekend with long hours of lectures. Convincing everyone, I'm sure, is not easy. But senior members of the batch managed to manage the rest of the group. So I could see team cohesiveness to a greater extent within you. Also, there was a very good communication between me, the unit, the coordinator, and the batch. Whenever there is a problem or a concern, they came to me to discuss. Found the best resolution rather than taking the problems to higher authorities. I'm sure none of the problems were taken to a higher level. I can state that in front of you with 100% assurance. Also, your organized, if I can remember, sundown on completion of your first year. And that shows the enthusiasm that your head towards this endeavor, the MBA, even though with a lot of hard work and other commitments, family commitments, office commitments, y'all went that extra mile to organize a sundown on the completion of your first year. Also, Poly Residential Style Tour was another landmark event. We asked to be cooperation, coordination, enthusiasm, support, all those immense. there were a lot of memories to carry home, which composed of three sections, namely within the tour industry day, tourism day, and university day. Apart from the intellectual speeches, also the students got a chance to get themselves exposed to the concepts like community tourism, and also experience the marvelous human automation by paying a visit to Kailasapathy motor company. Those were a few memories that I could capture. And these were only a few stories, but there are many. Yeah, I can go on and on and on for hours. I'm sure this is not the time for it. May I extend a big thank you to the weekday batch 2013-15, and it is your effort towards this endeavor is much valued. My dear students, you were a great batch, which I enjoyed 110% working with. May you be the best CEOs, best entrepreneurs, and best prophecies in Mother Sri Lanka. May the noble triple gem bless you. Have a pleasant evening and thank you.
In order to take the evening forward, I'd like to call Asanka to come up here and join me to take the rest of the events forward.
Welcome everyone. So I think everyone knows me. My name is Asanka. So my first task is to introduce the band. So we start with, we have Gayan on keyboards and Ingunil on bass and Nishika on percussion and Udara on guitar. Give a big round of applause for the band.